Hello, dear students. I am Dr. Mazhar Ali, and I welcome you to course Introduction to Artificial Intelligence. This is a second lecture on Introduction to Artificial Intelligence. In this lecture, I will discuss intelligence agents with you. This lecture is divided into two parts because in the first part, we will discuss just the brief introduction of intelligent agents. And in the second part, we will discuss the various types of intelligent agents. So an agent is anything that takes actions according to the information that it gains from the environment. Like a human agent. A human agent has a sensory organs to sense the environment and the body parts to act, while the robot agent has a sensors to perceive the environment. Means the artificial intelligence or any agents works on basis of some senses, as we sense different things from the environment, in which environment we are living. So we learn, we human learn from the environment, and what we learn, we act accordingly. Same, the agents work in the environment, and what they act, what they learn from the environment, they act accordingly. So intelligent agents or artificial and agents are often described schematically as an abstract functional system, which is similar to computer program. So abstract descriptions of intelligent agents are sometimes called abstract intelligent agents to distinguish them from their real world implementations as a computer system or a biological systems or organizations. So some autonomous intelligent agents are designed to function in the absence of human intervention. Because if you look in some organizations or industries where human cannot work, their artificial agents or intelligent agents or robots are working. Or in a space where human cannot go, their intelligent agents or robots are sent. Because these agents are working on behalf of the humans. They work like a human. So in artificial intelligence, in intelligent agent refers to an autonomous entity that aids directing its activity towards achieving goals using observation through sensors and consequent actuators. Actuators what are basically arms, like we are using arms to access something or do anything. Same, robots or intelligent agents are using actuators, which are working on behalf of arms. So intelligent agents may also learn or use knowledge to achieve their goals. They may be very simple or very complex. For example, a reflex machine such as a thermostat is considered an example of an intelligent agent. So we defined the agents, that what are agents. So therefore, an agent is an entity that perceives and acts. What perceives? What agent perceives from environment, in which environment it is working, and acts accordingly. What it learned from the environment, it would act accordingly. So if we talk about the human agents are also working same as intelligent agents, because intelligent agents, as I told you already, are developed on basis of human agents. So human agents are using their eyes to see or observe the things, and use their ears to listen or hear from the environment, and even human agents using the other organs for sensors like the eyes, nose, and their mind as well. Using also the hands, legs, mouth, and other body parts as actuators. So same artificial agents are working. So therefore, an artificial agent is anything that can be viewed as perceiving its environment, in which environment it is working. And how it perceives it? The agent perceives through its sensors and acting upon the environment through actuators. So, for example, a robot agent, if I talk about the robotic agents are using the cameras for sensing the things, and infrared range finders for the sensors. Means they find the range, they find the target through infrared rays, and even various motors for actuators which move the actuators of the robot, like the arms, legs, and other parts of the body. So this is the example of an intelligent agent. If you look here, even we human are working in this environment. So this is the environment. For example, this may be the real world in which we are living. This may be industry, this may be any organization, this may be a real world, and this is an intelligent agent. How it works? It perceives what is happening in the environment. It perceives, it gets information, it gets knowledge from the environment through its sensors, means cameras and other programs which are installed in the machine. And then after perceiving the environment, perceiving the different things from environment, the agent performs actions. Now, how agent performs actions? With its actuators. So if you look here, the arm is the actuator, leg is the actuator. And it perceives through cameras and other things. So it works like a human. There are different sensors which are connected through infrared and other communication tools. Even this is the diagram. And it's the same like this one. It's the same. So this is a diagram. This is an agent. If is a computer science student or artificial intelligence student, you have to definitely, before developing the agent, you have to design the diagram. So this is a diagram, and this is an agent. And the agent is using different sensors, so different cameras and other things. And these are the actuators. These through actuators, agent is connected with the environment, and it perceives through the sensors. So what AI should feel? Definitely AI should feel as per the function, as per the requirement, that in which environment agent is working. So same should be filled by the AI specialist. In artificial intelligence, there are simple terms are used for agents. So like the percept and the percept sequence. So agents in artificial intelligence are the associated concepts that the AI technology, AI means artificial intelligence, that the AI technologies work upon. The AI software or AI enabled devices with the sensors generally captures the information from the environment setup and process the data for further actions, as we discussed in previous slides. So there are mainly two ways the agent interacts with the environment, such as a perception, means a perception, and actions. So the person is only passive for capturing the information without changing the actual environment, whereas action is the active form of interaction by changing the actual environment. Artificial intelligence technologies such as virtual assistants, CAT boards, AI enabled devices to work based on the previous perception data and processing and learning the actions. So if you talk about the perception or percept, so perception is a basically passive interaction where the agent gains information about the environment without changing the environment. The sensors of the robot help it to gain information about the surroundings without affecting the surrounding as well. So, because the agent is working in some specific environment or for a specific purpose, hence gaining information through sensors is called perception. Means what you gain through the sensors is basically percept or perceptions. So a percept is an input that an intelligent agent is perceiving at any given moment. It is essentially the same concept as percept in psychology, except that it is being perceived not by the brain but by the agent. So a percept is detected by a sensor, often a camera, processed accordingly and act upon by an actuator. Same we are taking, we perceive from environment. For example, we get some anything we look or we see when we go out of home, even home, what we see, that we perceive. And how we see through our eyes. And when we see or watch or feel or touch, then it goes to our brain. And that is our perception. And brain performs actions, and we perform that action through our actuators, eyes, legs, arms, and so on. Therefore, same in the agent, percept is detected by a sensor, often camera, as we perceive through eyes, nose, and so on. So each percept is added to a percept sequence, which is a complete history of each percept ever detected. The agent's action at any instant point may depend on the entire percept sequence up to the instant point. Same, what we perceive from the information, we keep on our mind, and there is a sequence that is developed, and we perform according to same sequence. So an intelligent agent chooses how to act not only based on the current percept, but the percept sequence. The next action is chosen by the agent function with the MAPS. Every percept to an action. For example, if you are developing the automatic car, so there should be an agent, and agent perceive the map and path and addresses and keep in the sequence and perform as per sequence of percept sequence. So for example, if a camera were to record a gesture, the agent would process the percept, calculate the corresponding special vectors, examine this percept history, and use the agent program. For example, the application of agent function will to act accordingly. So action performed on basis of these percept sequences. So action is an active intervention where the environment is changed. When the robot moves an obstacle using its arm, it is called an action as the environment is changed. So the arm of a robot is called an effector as it acts. It's basically actuator, but technically in the robotic forms, we call it the effector because its action affects something. When it is known that the action of agent depends completely on the perceptual history, the concept sequence, then the agent can be described by using a mapping. So mapping is a list that maps the percept sequence. Then the agent can be described by using a mapping. So it is a percept sequence to the actions. These actions are performed on the percept sequence. So when we specify which action an agent should be corresponding to the given percept sequence, then we are specifying the design for an ideal agent. So agent's structure can be viewed as agent. Means agent is equal to architecture plus agent program. If you are going to develop the agent, intelligent agent, first of all, you will design its architecture, then you will program as per the requirement. So architecture basically is the machinery, means you will make some machinery that an agent executes on. And agent program is an implementation of an agent function that for what purpose you are going to develop the agent. So mathematically, an agent behavior can be described by an agent function. So agent function is the mapping of a given percept sequence to sequence to an action. It is an abstract mathematical explanation. Since the agent program is the practical and physical implementation of the agent function. So for example, an agent hand dryer detects signals hands through its sensors. When we bring hands nearby the dryer, it turns on the heating circuit and below air. So when the signal detection disappears, it breaks the heating circuit and stops blowing air. So an agent program is a real implementation of an agent function, means what you developed in the function that will be implemented in the agent program. As I told you, a function mapping any given percept sequence to an action, because action will be performed on basis of these functions. And practically, it is described by an agent program. So despite the agent function that can hold all history of percepts, an agent program can only take one input, means current input. Agent may take current input at a time, because there is nothing available at the time. So think about it. An agent program takes snapshots of the environment, even though it takes multiple snapshots at the same time. They will be identical, definitely. So this is an example of a vacuum cleaner. So here you look here, the perception is basically the agent vacuum cleaner will take perception from environment that either environment is clean or dirty and where it is in. Means for example, you are cleaner is working in the room. So where is dirt is available? And which parts are clear? So if you look here, these are the dirty areas. These are dirty areas of the rooms. And its perception, the vacuum cleaner will perform the actions. It means move left, right, and suck the dirt. And definitely, what it find where it find the dirt, it will suck. Reflex agent works similar to the reflex action of our body. For example, when we immediately lift our finger when it touches the tip of the flames, what we feel? We feel some burning if our tip of our finger touch the flame. So just as the prompt response of our body based on the current situation, the agent also responds based on the current environment irrespective of the past state of the environment. So the reflex agent can work properly only if the decisions to be made are based on the current percept. For example, the vacuum cleaner reflex agent functions, as I told you in the previous slides. So they choose actions only based on the current percept, means the return value or response as per percept. And they are rational only if a correct decision is made only on the basis of current percepts. Their environment is completely observable. So if you look here, if the status is equal to dirty, then return suck. Means if a vacuum cleaner finds dirt in the room, it will perform action of sucking. And else if location, for example, it finds that dirt is available in the right side, then it will move to the right side. Means, and if it find the location on the B side, means the left side, then it move to the left side. So definitely these functions are performed on basis of perception and percept sequence. concept of rationality, and so rationality is the quality or a state of being rational, that is being based on or agreeable to reason. So rationality implies the conformity of one's belief with one's reason to believe, and of one's actions with one's reasons for actions. Therefore, it is the status of being reasonable or sensible and having a good sense of judgment. Rationality is concerned with the expected actions and results depending upon what the agent has perceived. Agent means intelligent agent. So performing actions with the aim of obtaining useful information is an important part of rationality. An ideal rational agent is the one which is capable of doing expected actions to maximize its performance measure on the basis of means its percept sequence and its built-in knowledge base. Knowledge base, definitely when you develop the agent, you have to develop the knowledge base. On the basis of knowledge base, it interact with the environment and perform the actions as well. So the rationality of an agent depends on the performance measure, means the performance measures which determine the degree of success, agent's percept sequence till now, and the agent's prior knowledge about the environment and the action that the agent can carry out. So a rational agent is an agent has clear preferences and model uncertainty via expected values. A rational agent can be anything that makes decision typically like a person, firm, machine or a software. Therefore, a rational agent always perform the right action, where the right action means the action that causes the agent to be most successful in the given percept sequence. The problem the agent solves is characterized by performance measure, environment, actuators, and sensors as well. So, rational agent is basically one that does the right thing, what it perceives, and it matches with the knowledge-based systems. So, every entry in the table for the agent function is correct, means the rational. It should be rational. And what is the rational or correct means the action that causes the agent to be most successful. Means when you are assigned a task and you fulfill that task or finish the task successfully or properly, then it would be the successful work or action. So we need the ways to measure the success, that how much it is accurate. So definitely the functions or the actions of the agents will be measured through its accuracy of working. The rational agent that we are aiming at should be successful in the task it is performing. Therefore, to assess the success, we need to have a performance measure, as we discussed in the previous slide. So, because the performance measure of an agent defines the criteria of success, the agent's prior knowledge of the environment helps the agent in reaching the target and giving the successful performance. The actions that the agent can perform depends on the agent's percept sequence to date. For each possible percept sequence, a rational agent should select an action that is expected to maximize its performance measure given the evidence provided by the percept sequence and whatever built-in knowledge the agent has. So, means when you assign the task to an agent, that is definitely an objective function that the agent have to determine and it agent have to fulfill. And what is the accuracy means how the agent does successfully, how agent finish the task successfully, for example 90%, 50%, 60%, 30%, what The accuracy will show the performance and successful action of the agent. So an agent based on his percepts, definitely the percepts depends on the action sequence. And action sequence working on basis of percept sequence. Omniscience agent, or an omniscience agent is an agent that knows the actual outcome of its action in advance. However, such agents are impossible in the real world, because in the real world we don't know that how we will we don't know things in advance, but we learn through our experience and working. So rational agents are different from the omniscient agents, because a rational agent tries to get the best possible outcome with the current perception, which leads to imperfection. For example, a chess game can be a good example of a rational agent, because with the current action, it is not possible to foresee every possible outcome. If you are playing the chess game or any game, you don't know that what will happen in the next step. So that is the rational, that is the real. There is a Titic toy. AI is the omniscient, is it always knows the outcome in advance. For example, you know, if you look at the snake game, so if you know you may reach at this position or at this position, even if the we were playing a game in our childhood, we draw the circles and so on. So we may know that by how I win if by connecting these circles. So we know in advance, that is the omniscience. An agent who knows it's working in advance, knows is each and everything. Since the rational agent works on basis of current perception, what he perceives, what it perceives, it keep in the percept sequence and performs as accordingly. But omniscience does not do that. So an omniscient agent knows the actual outcome of its actions and acts accordingly, which is not possible in a reality. An omniscient agent knows what impact the action will have and can act accordingly. But in a reality, it is not possible. So no other possible outcomes than this. So as I told you, the tic-tac-toe, a very famous game of childhood. Now, learning makes the experience. So does a rational agent depend, or it works only on basis of current percepts, what it perceives, what it learned from the environment? The rational agent works accordingly, or rational agent acts accordingly. So learning makes them the perfect. So is the agents time to time are working good. Their accuracy is increasing time to time, because their percept sequences are developing time to time. So an agent, when it learns from the environment or perceives different things from environment and keep those perceptions in a percept history, is called basically learning. So after experience episode means after the learning, learning is basically experience of an agent. So after experiencing an episode, the agent should adjust its behavior to perform better for the same job next time. So the behavior of an agent depends on its own experiences as well as the built-in knowledge of the agent instilled by the agent designer. So a system is basically then, after learning, developing, their system is basically developing and working more accurate. A system is autonomous if it takes actions according to its experience. So for the initial phase, as it does not have any experience, it is good to provide built-in knowledge. The agent learns then through evaluation. Evolution means agent learns from the evolution. So a truly autonomous intelligent agent, if given sufficient time to adopt, should be able to operate successfully in a wide variety of environment, because an agent just relies on the prior knowledge of its designer rather than its own perception than the agent. So agent learn what is available in the knowledge base and what it gets from the environment and what are the perceptions which it perceives from environment. So definitely these things make the agent automatic, means their autonomy is increased and they working or they response automatically, no need to further things, because knowledge base is improving day to day by perceiving different perceptions or things from the environment. Knowledge base is increasing and developing. So agent is going to be more accurate and its accuracy is going to be more automatic. So a rational agent should be autonomous. It should learn what it can to compensate for a partial or incorrect prior knowledge. For example, a clock, there is no input, means no percepts, but run only, but its own algorithm. Its own algorithm, prior knowledge, means what is the prior knowledge, what is the prior algorithm in that. So definitely for a clock, there is no learning, no experience, but an automatic agent needs some learning algorithms and experiences which it gets from the environment. The experience means the perceptions which it perceives from the environment. Now, agent may be a hardware agent like the robot or other things. And agent may be the software agent. So a software agent is a persistent goal-oriented computer program that reacts to its environment and runs without continuous direct supervision to perform some function for an end user or another program. Some, but not all, software agents have user interfaces. Some agents have user interface and some have not. So it is a software program that works in a dynamic environment. These agents are also known as soft boards, because all body parts of software agents are software only. For example, video games, flight simulators, and etc. These all are the examples of software agents. So if you use the flight simulator, you will feel that you are flying the aeroplane. And even the video games, these are very automatic and rational. So these are also types of the software agents, even the internet tools. So they are all artificial, but a very complex environment, because software agents are not working in the real world, but they are working in the some man-made environments or computerized environments. So those agents working in these environments are called software agent or soft boards, because all parts of the agents are software. Now that every agent is working as per task or the task environment. So an agent is anything that can perceive its environment through sensors and act upon the environment through effectors. So static environments are easy to deal with the because an agent does not need to continue looking at the world while designing foreign action, because that agent is working in some static environment. However, for a dynamic environment, agent needs to know, looking at the world at each action, because it's not static, it's a dynamic. Anything may come, anything may have to face by the agent, like a taxi driving is an example of a dynamic environment, whereas crossword puzzles are an example of a static environment. And taxi driver, you don't know which vehicle may come or cross you, or how, where, means you will change the roads and path and so on. But if you play the puzzle game, that is an static environment. So a task environment is a problem to which a rational agent is designed as a solution. Consequently, in 2003, Russell and Norweg introduced several ways to classify task environments. However, before classifying the environment, we should be aware of the some terms. For example, performance measure. Performance measure specifies the agent's sequence of steps taken to achieve its target by measuring different factors. And environment. Environment also specifies the interaction of the agent with the different types of environments. Actuators specify the way the agent affects the environment by taking expected actions. And the sensors specify the way the agent gets information from its environment, because sensors like the cameras, it perceive the different things or perceptions from the environment through sensors and perform actions through actuators. And their performance is basically performance may be measured on basis of accuracy, that how much accuracy is there, is how much agents are working successfully. So these all tasks may be called the acronym of these tasks is the P's, means the performance. What is the performance? How much it is accurate, and in which environment these agents are working, what type of this environment, either static or dynamic, and how they perform actions, means they perform actions through actuators, and how they sense the environment, how they sense the task, how they sense the target through sensors like the cameras and so on. So as I give you example of the taxi driver using these all things to reach the target, to perform the successfully. So the environment, now environment, a taxi must deal with a variety of roads. That is the environment. For the taxi driver, the environments are roads, paths, traffic lights, and different vehicles, pedestrians, which are walking on the paths, even animals, road. These all things are part of its environment. So taxi driver has to perceive these all things and work accordingly. And the actuators are basically output by which agent is working or performing actions. And the sensors are basically input by which it inputs or detect the different vehicles, road situations, signals, lights, and animals, persons, and so on, what are running on the road. So these are the example of the task environment. For example, the taxi driver. So performance measure, the driving should be safe, fast, legal, comfortable, and so on. And environment, roads and other traffic, pedestrians and so on, as I told you. And it works, give output means through actuators like the strings, accelerator, brake and so on. And sensors are the cameras, sonar, speedometers and so on. Now, properties of a task. So these may be the fully observable and partially observable. So when an agent's sensor allows access to the complete state of environment at each point of time, then the task environment is fully observable. Whereas if the agent does not have a complete and relevant information on the environment, then the task environment is partially observable. So, for example, a taxi driver or automatic car or a taxi driver, if it does not know about the environment, then definitely it will ask or get help from others, and definitely that will be the partially observable. For example, in the checker game, if you played ever, the agent observes the environment completely, while in a poker game, the agent partially observes the environment because it cannot see the cards of the other agent. However, fully observable task environments are convenient as there is no need to maintain the internal state to keep track of the world. Another property of task is the deterministic versus stochastic. So if the agent's current state and action completely determine the next state of the environment, means if agent knows, agent completed the all the required actions or determined all the required actions to reach the next state, then the environment is called deterministic. Because agent knows, agent has determined all the states to know the other state. Whereas, if the next state cannot be determined by the agent from the current state and actions, then the environment is a stochastic. So, stochastic is an environment about the agent does not know. However, the deterministic environment, agent knows about the environment. So, for example, image analysis is a deterministic, and taxi driving is static because the taxi driver does not know that, what to be happen. Another property is episodic versus sequential. So if the agent's episodes are divided into atomic episodes and the next episode does not depend on the previous state actions, then the environment is episodic. Whereas if current action may affect the future decision, such environment is called sequential. So an episode means agent's single pair of perception and action. The quality of the agent's action does not depend on other episodes. Therefore, every episode is independent of each other. So, episodic environment is simpler. The agent does not need to think ahead. However, in the sequential, current action may affect all future decisions. What you are doing now, if you are not doing properly, you will face difficulties in future as well. So, if the taxi driver is not driving and not taking the proper path, it may face problems. Even in a chess game, if you are not playing the game with the proper sense, you will face several problems. Another, so these properties means that if the environment changes with the time and environment is a dynamic, otherwise the environment is a static. This is also property of the environment task. So a dynamic environment is always changing over time. For example, the number of people in the street may be 2, may be 4. So these the number is changing time to time. While in the static environment, for example, the destination will be same. You have to go anywhere. You target the destination will be same. And in a semi-dynamic, so environment is not changed over time, but the agent's performance score does change, definitely. Another property of task is a discrete and continuous. So if an agent has a finite number of actions and states, then the environment is a discrete, otherwise continuous. So for example, in a checker game, there is a finite number of moves. That is definitely discrete. And a truck can have infinite moves while reaching its destination. That is a continuous. So if there are a limited number of distinct states, clearly defined percepts and actions, the environment is a discrete, like the chess game, and continuous is like the taxi driving. Another single agent versus a multi agent. So when a single agent works to achieve a goal, it is known as a single agent. Whereas when two or more agents work together to achieve a goal, they are known as a multi agent. For example, playing a crossword puzzle is a single agent. Playing a chess, there's a need of multiple agents, so it will be multi agents. In the known environment, the agent knows the outcomes of its actions. But in an unknown environment, the agent needs to learn from the environment in order to make good decisions. So the distinction refers not to the environment itself, but to the agent's or designer's state knowledge about the environment. So in the known environment, the outcomes for all actions are given. So if the environment is unknown, the agent will have to learn how it works in order to make good decisions. So for example, a tennis player knows the rules and outcomes of its actions, while the player needs to learn the rules of a new video game. Same. So these are the examples of task environments, like the crossword puzzle, chase with a clock. So observable, definitely these are the fully observable, and the crossword deterministic, and chase with a clock is a strategic, and episodic is a definitely, both are sequential. So these are the task environments which I discussed with you in the previous slides. Here it is just for your single view, that you may see in these all tasks in a single view. So thank you very much for watching the part one of intelligent agents, in which we briefly discussed the functions and working environment of the agents and task and the different types of the task in this lecture. In the next lecture, we will discuss the different types of the intelligence agents. Till next lecture, take care, be happy, watch the lecture, and share with your friends who cannot attend this lecture. Subscribe this channel, that you may get the future lectures automatically. And if you feel good, you may like this lecture. Take care.